Everybody has that spot in their house that's kind of like a catch-all for everything as you get home. That's just that one spot where you throw everything. So today it was cold, and when I got home, I no longer needed my coat and I threw it on top of my catch-all. However, I've just recently remembered that there's an assignment that is coming up that's very important, but I don't remember exactly when it was due. I know that it was given to me and the teacher said I had a week. So if I can figure out about when the teacher gave it to me, it gives me a better idea of how long I have to complete that assignment. So I'm going to use the items in my catch-all to help me figure out when that day was. Now the easiest is the thing on top. It's my jacket. I just threw this in there today, so that's the most recent. As I go down through this, I know I'm getting to older and older objects. So I can find things in here. I apparently threw a football in there. I also have a science notebook, which I know was given to me after the assignment was due. I have my science notebook, which has the assignment in it that needs to be completed. I have a folder, which happens to still have a late slip that was written for me in it. So that's going to give me a very important date as well. I have just a random bag. And then I have a picture packet, and I sort of remember when this was given to me. So I have all of these items that gives me a sort of column, and I can kind of diagram that out as you see. Now I need to start placing some dates on it. So we're going to start with the most recent thing, the jacket. Now the jacket was today. So let's say that today happens to be a Saturday. It was a day off of school. I had gotten home, I threw it in there, which also explains why I had the football. Maybe I was using that after school on Friday or Thursday. I just don't remember. I work my way farther back. I know I've got my book, which was given after the assignment, but I don't remember exactly what day. I just know that it was towards the end of the week. So I could maybe narrow that down to a Thursday or a Friday, but I don't remember exactly which day. I have the assignment in question, which is what I'm trying to determine, and I have my late slip. Now this late slip is a very important clue. This late slip tells me that on Tuesday, I was late to class. Okay, well, that makes sense. I have a bag, and then I know the picture packet was also given to me at the beginning of the week. So although I don't know when the bag was put in there, I can say that the picture packet was given sometime around Monday or Tuesday. So as I'm looking at this column, I can see that my assignment is going to be due sometime after that Monday and Tuesday time period, and it's going to come before Thursday or Friday. Now, I may not know the exact date, but I'm pretty sure this assignment was given to me on Wednesday based off of the relative dates that I've gotten and the absolute date that I got from that slip. That gives me a much better clue of when this assignment might be due. So now I can determine that, hey, if this was given to me on about Wednesday, it's probably going to be due on the Wednesday of the next week. I should have it done by Tuesday just to be safe in case I'm a day off. So that's one example of how I could use relative dating and even one instance of absolute dating to help me determine when something was due. This is very similar to what we do with fossils. Some fossils, we know exactly when it was created, right? It was in a rock layer in which we could use absolute dating and we could find out the exact date. The other rock layers around it, we know that relative to when that was created, it could be relatively younger if the rock layer and fossil is found above, or relatively older if that rock layer and fossil is found below. So this is the importance behind relative dating and absolute dating, not only with fossils, but potentially something that might come up in your everyday life.